live from WTVO 17 and your home team. Eyewitness News at 5 starts now.
Governor J.B. Pritzker providing an update on the state's latest COVID-19 response. His message to business owners refusing to mask up. A State Line service member celebrates 100 trips around the sun, the group he cares for now after years spent serving his country. And you might not be jetting off on your dream vacation this year, but the pandemic hasn't stopped Illinoisans from exploring their own backyards. Dive into a southern Illinois lake on this week's Destination Illinois. Good evening, I'm Hannah Zettl. Thanks for joining us tonight. Illinois Governor J.B. Pritzker doubling down on the new emergency rules filed Friday that would punish businesses ignoring public health requirements. Those that don't abide face fines of $75 to $2,500. Pritzker says health officials would give businesses enough warning to improve issues before fining them. The governor adding that rules are intended to protect citizens whose bosses won't enforce public health rules while giving local leaders more options.
This rule is going to give them the enforcement mechanism so that county boards of public health, local law enforcement, local public officials have the ability to enforce masks and physical distancing.
And on the topic of schools, the governor added that the rules give the state the, quote, best chance of preserving in-person learning options. The number of positive COVID-19 cases in Illinois surpasses 194,000. That's after 1,382 new cases are confirmed today, including 8 additional deaths. This brings the state case total to 194,080 cases, with 7,636 lives lost since the start of the pandemic. The 7-day positivity rate now stands at 4.1%. And locally, Winnebago County health officials will provide a COVID-19 update tomorrow. A Wisconsin veteran is celebrating his 100th birthday this weekend, and after decades spent serving those around him, the favor is returned. Our Michelle Rave recaps his birthday to remember from Janesville.
Happy birthday, dear Sal. Happy birthday to you.
It was a memorable birthday for World War II veteran Salvador Peirce, who turned 100 this year. Peirce has been a volunteer at St. Mary's Hospital in Janesville for 7 years.
Wish you a happy birthday and tell you how much you mean to us. You're a wonderful volunteer. You do wonderful work.
Hospital staff surprised the vet at his doorstep with balloons, a card, and of course, cake. Salvador, known to many as Sal, is a cherished volunteer.
He's put in over 1,500 hours here. He works in our town square. That's the main entrance of the hospital, and he helps transport patients, tidies up, greets people. There's not anyone here that cannot say how much they love him.
And there were about at least 20 people out there, the whole crowd that came to the hospital. And they brought me a few presents.
Peirce served in the Army for 3.5 years during World War II. Several years later, he worked for the Chicago Transit Authority, and once he retired, he moved to Janesville. Peirce stopped volunteering at the hospital when the pandemic hit and says he misses interacting with patients.
I guess I'd just like to talk to people and be active. They're very grateful for whatever help we give them. You'd be surprised how grateful these people appear, even though they're sick.
Peirce's daughter, Rosemary, says her father's active lifestyle is to thank for his 100 healthy years.
He likes the morning shift to get there in the morning, and if he needs to help someone with a wheelchair and help them through, he does, because he's a good physical health.
As for Peirce, he's just excited to get the all clear to return to St. Mary's.
Yes, I do, definitely.
Well, we're very proud because he's out living the world, I guess, the way he is, but he's healthy. That's the most important thing.
Reporting in Janesville for your home team, I'm Michelle Rave.
A popular family-owned business known for its fall traditions announces its opening date with a twist. Edwards Apple Orchard in Poplar Grove will open for drive-through service on August 28th. To keep staff and customers safe during uncertain times, donuts, apples, ciders, and a list of other autumn specialties can be purchased near the lower parking lot. COVID-19 concerns will keep the apple barn, cider cellar, and play area closed this season. The orchard has been open since 1964. And Belvidere residents wrapping up their weekend on a high note with a Buchanan Street stroll. Community members enjoyed food trucks, small business vendors, and live music. Belvidere neighbors aren't the only ones excited to get back to the community event.
We're able to be out performing for people and bringing music to people's lives. And to us, that's joy in itself to us.
Tonight's fun wraps up in about an hour, but the next Buchanan Street stroll is set for this Saturday from 5 to 10 p.m. The COVID-19 pandemic might be keeping some residents from hopping on a plane to paradise, but our latest edition of Destination Illinois shows one vacation option not too far from home. Reporter Amelia Henderson has the details on one of Southern Illinois' getaways.
With only a few lakes in the state of Illinois, Lake Shelbyville is one of the biggest, with 172 miles of lakeshore.
It's one of the biggest in southern Illinois.
Despite the global pandemic, Lake Shelbyville has seen a record number of visitors in 2020.
For the whole month of June and July, you know, our beaches were, you know, people were driving miles and miles and hours to come, you know, to use our facilities. So it's been a very interesting year, but with everything that's going on, right now, I think people have really found Lake Shelbyville.
With the miles of shoreline at this lake, it makes it easy for guests to enjoy the many water activities it has to offer.
From swimming, using the day use areas to picnic, going boating, hunting, and camping.
Although boating and jet skiing are a popular activity on the lake, the main attraction is the fishing.
I would say fishing is number one, just because you have the opportunity to do that longer. It's a longer season than just your regular pleasure boaters.
Great crappie fishery. Walleye fishery is very good in here. So there's definitely trophy walleye, trophy crappie.
And we currently hold the state record for muskie. We also have an organization called the Lake Shelbyville Fish Habitat Alliance that has been doing some tremendous work around the lake, putting different artificial structures in to help with the fishing, and it seems to be working.
While water activities are the main attraction, the original purpose of Lake Shelbyville is to prevent flooding through the dam.
The number one mission here at Lake Shelbyville is for flood control, and the reason why that was needed is because of the excessive flooding that was done downstream. So, you know, that's Lake Shelbyville's number one purpose.
Despite the global pandemic, Lake Shelbyville is one location still offering all amenities through the remainder of 2020. At Lake Shelbyville for Destination Illinois, I'm Amelia Henderson.
Eyewitness News, your home team, with Hannah Zettl, sports anchor Samantha Rivera, and chief meteorologist Candice King.
As the Trump administration and Democratic leaders butt heads over coronavirus relief, the president signing four executive actions Saturday to aid struggling Americans. Correspondent Deirdre Bolton has the latest from New York.
The United States, now with 5 million confirmed cases and more than 162,000 deaths from coronavirus. The pandemic throwing the economy into crisis. Millions of unemployed Americans have been relying on the $600 a week supplemental federal unemployment payment, a benefit that expired on July 31st. Talks on Capitol Hill to extend those payments collapsed on Friday.
Therefore, I'm taking executive action. We've had it.
On Saturday, President Trump bypassing Congress, signing four executive actions.
Through these four actions, my administration will provide immediate and vital relief to Americans struggling in this difficult time.
The president seeking to restore unemployment benefits, but slashing the weekly checks to $400, requesting that states share the cost. Also, minimizing evictions, suspending interest on federal student loans, and enacting payroll tax cuts. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi not mincing words.
What the president did is, I agree with the Republican senator, said it was unconstitutional slop. While it has the illusion of saying we're going to have a moratorium on evictions, it says, I'm going to ask you, the folks in charge to study if that's feasible. While he says he's going to do the payroll tax, what he's doing is undermining Social Security and Medicare.
Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin says that's not the case.
That's just factually inaccurate. There'd be no reduction to those benefits, and the president's made that very clear.
Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer calling the executive orders unworkable.
Most states will take months to implement it because it's brand new. It's sort of put together with spit and paste.
But the president's top economic advisor disagrees.
The states are the ones that process the federal benefits before. So I don't see any reason why it'd be all that difficult.
There's also the question of whether states can afford to chip in 25% of that $400 benefit.
The answer is I don't know yet, but I think what really needs to happen is Congress needs to get back in and negotiate.
That was Deirdre Bolton reporting.
Now, your first warm weather forecast with Chief Meteorologist Candice King.
Well, it's felt a little more like summer this weekend with temperatures climbing into the mid and upper 80s, that heat index going up, making it feel more like the 90s. The heat index here this afternoon, low to mid 90s. And with the return of some of that moisture, we've also had a return of some showers and thunderstorms. No severe weather at the moment, as a lot of these thunderstorms, at least locally, have remained under severe limits, but still could pose wind gusts upwards of 40 to even 50 miles per hour with some of the stronger thunderstorms. And then we have some very heavy rainfall. In fact, this one particular cluster of storms moving right along the Wisconsin-Illinois border. Here we are in Rock County. This is Broadhead. This is Monroe, and now in Greene County. And then down here over northeastern Stevenson County, we've got a few thunderstorms that will have some heavy rainfall, frequent lightning with them too. Kind of weakening a little bit as that storm progresses a bit further off to the east, but nonetheless, watch for some gusty winds. Now, these storms will continue to hug the Wisconsin-Illinois border and most likely remain north of Highway 20. They are gaining some height here, rating about 30 to 35,000 feet in the atmosphere. So definitely dealing with the potential for some wind, maybe some small hail. Hail not too much of a threat here for us. It primarily would be the frequent lightning as well as the winds gusting with that. You go a little bit further to the south, and any activity, if we see any of that here this evening, is going to stay fairly isolated. So let's kind of time this out as we go through the overnight. We will hang on to a few of those thunderstorms through about 9-10 o'clock this evening. Isolated thunderstorm chance then as we go into the midnight hour. The thunderstorms that are moving through now were tied into kind of this weak area of low pressure, and so it's building into some of that instability. We might see a few isolated storms through sunrise tomorrow, but a better chance come late tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow evening as a cold front begins to move through. A live look with our Mercy House SkyTrack camera out at the Park Hills Golf Course in Freeport. Temperature in Freeport at 81. We've cooled down now to 69 here in Monroe. 85 our current temperature in Rockford. Our weather watcher Jim checking in this evening with 87 and a dew point temperature of 71. That's what's made it feel a little bit more muggy out there. And you see a lot of that moisture with the dew points in the upper 60s, low to mid 70s. With that southerly wind. But there is a cold front back here across the plains. That's actually where a lot of the severe weather has been late this afternoon and early evening. That front will come through during the afternoon hours tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be another muggy and warm day, but thunderstorms will form along that front as we go towards the afternoon. Now, as I mentioned, we could see a couple of showers and a few isolated thunderstorms tomorrow morning, but a better chance will line up as we go through the afternoon. Here's that cold front as it moves across southern Wisconsin tomorrow. Likely we'll see more cloud cover tomorrow than what we did for today. Through about 4, 5, 6, 7 o'clock tomorrow, that's kind of our window. We'll see some of those showers and thunderstorms move through. Some of those could be on the stronger side, again, with wind being our primary threat. That'll end about midnight. High pressure then builds in once we get into Monday night and Tuesday, and that'll help dry us out at least for a couple of days. So very muggy tonight, only down to 74, up to 88 tomorrow afternoon. Isolated thunderstorm chance in the morning. Better chance comes with us during the afternoon. So just make sure you kind of keep an eye on the radar. Low to mid 80s Tuesday, Wednesday, and then we'll stay in the upper 80s here as we head towards the end of this week.
Now, the Mapleton Sports Desk with Samantha Rivera.
Well, hopefully by now you've had some time to let it sink in. It's not a dream. The Chicago Blackhawks are officially set to play the Vegas Golden Knights in the first round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Of course, one of the biggest storylines since we learned about the matchup has been the Hawks most likely taking on former teammate Robin Leonard. So how do the Hawks feel about playing him? Well, naturally, they had nothing but great things to say about the now Vegas goalie. But facing a team as good as the Golden Knights, the Blackhawks also know they can't just be focused on him.
You know, obviously, the goaltender is a big part of their team. I think we just got to, you know, continue to do the right things and play the right way, and the chances for us will come. Robin's proven over the years he's a great goaltender, and he's out in the playoffs as well. So it's a great test for us. He's your great goaltender. I think our focus is on Vegas as a whole, but looking forward to playing this.
The first round schedule is expected to be released soon. The Winnebago Crosstown Classic wrapped up earlier today. It took place at Ledges Golf Course on Saturday and today at Atwood Homestead. Brian Silvers was tied for the lead with Ron Reese after the two-shot on an opening round 69. Silvers turned up the heat on the back nine. He played the par 5 13th beautifully. His second shot left him right here below the green, and he'd go and clean up with this chip shot just a few feet from the cup. He tapped that in for birdie. To the 18th, Silvers said he thought he was tied with Matt LaMarca after LaMarca dropped back-to-back birdies on the final two holes. There's the one on 18. Silvers tapped this in for par, and upon turning in his scorecard, he found out he was indeed the champion. Silvers has had some close finishes at previous tournaments, but this is his first win of the summer. Members of the Boylan women's golf team were getting some last-minute practice in before the start of their season tomorrow. Sisters Ella and Eva Greenberg were paired together with Morgan Canova and Tessa Lawson. Older sister Ella led the way both days. She shot a 74 on day one and followed it up with a 73 today. She took home the victory for the women's division, defeating Kayla Silin by 3 strokes. Let's head over to the NBA bubble. Grizzlies taking on the Raptors third quarter. Toronto up 66-59. Fred VanVleet with the layup there. And later, we head to the fourth quarter. Toronto still up 91-73. Ja Morant will bring us this slam there. But the Raptors just kept it coming. Pascal Siakam will drill the step back three there. Then it's VanVleet with the steal. Gets it ahead to Siakam, who feeds Kyle Lowry for the reverse layup as the Raptors go on to win 108-99. Siakam finished with 26 points and VanVleet with 14.
We had a couple of thunderstorms we're keeping a close eye on. Nothing severe at the moment, but a few of the stronger storms moving across far northeastern Stevenson County, now over far northwest Winnebago County, could pose a risk for some winds gusting 40 to even 50 miles per hour as the storm's moving off to the east and northeast. So heads up for you folks in Beloit, South Beloit, Roscoe, Rockton. This might skim just to the north, at least the strongest part of this thunderstorm, right in through here. Might skim just to the north of you folks there in McChesney Park and Loves Park. As far as our temperatures here these next couple of days, we'll stay in the 80s as we go through the end of the week.
That's all we've got for you tonight. We'll see you back here at 10.